Strange. Should that have locked? Okay. Just gotta find Cosmo. Then I can deal with the team. If I can find them.
Peter, there's something out there. But I won't tell you what it is. Because I think being distant makes me mysterious.
Cosmo? That you? Oh, I hate mazes. Especially stinking brain mazes. Okay, dude. Deep breath. Deep breath.
I am Groot.
Stop being so nice to a brow grumble hiss!
Flark!
I give myself a heart attack.
Got here.
Watch it, Star-Lord.
And what's a filthy scut-stained Terran doing out here, Rawson?
Hiding's what I think, Garrick.
Aye. Terrans always be hiding.
Cause everybody knows Terrans are scrawny.
And good for eating.
If you're into that.
We might be into that. Except for the bounty.
Hey, guys! Wouldn't happen to know where Cosmo's office is, would you? I get the distinct feeling that you're looking for someone of the Earth persuasion. I get it, man. I get it. Us Earthers, we all look the same. It's not like you guys, who very clearly look different.
Get to the point, Terran.
The point is I can help you find who you're actually looking for.
Terrans do all look the same.
Except this Terran's got a word on his back. Just like the bounty says.
What's that word on your back say?
I heard nowhere.
Well, maybe it says Star-Lord. Either way. Get him!
We've been hired to clobber some Terran with words on his jacket.
Lots of people have jackets.
Yeah, but you're the one the lady wanted. So hurry up and die!
Wait, did Lady A want him alive?
Lady H, whatever Lady Hailbender's paying you, I'll double it.
No dice! You don't cross Lady H!
Triple! I'll triple it!
Yeah, now, Ron.
Get crushed!
Have a choga dog! Cover this over!
His mouth moves more than his jumping boots!
Gonna stop him in two!
Look! Guys! This is a big misunderstanding!
That's how we make our unit!
Okay. Yep, time out. Woo! Heart is pumping. Guys, it's very clear that we're evenly matched.
Ha! No, we ain't. We're completely invincible.
Oh, well, that sucks. But we're all professionals here, right? Right? Maybe we can work something out.
Peter! Shoot now! We need to keep them separated! Draw them apart before shooting, Peter! I'll enjoy this! They've had this trap ready for a while!
It's gonna be sick. It's about these zombies that invade Earth, and then it's up to these kids that have to blow them away.
Of course you would remember that. And then I ask you if you packed your lunch and you give me a blank stare.
I'll be careful, Ma. I always am.
Not so fast. Before you go, there's something I want to talk to you about, something I want to give you.
$20?
Don't push it. Think of it as a long overdue gift from your father. It's upstairs on my bed. Go on and get it while I finish up in the kitchen. And we can open it together. Ahem. I knew you wouldn't wait. Do you know what a birthright is, Peter? It's something that's a part of you. Like your name. Before your father returned to space...
Mom...
I know it sounds crazy and that you've never believed me, but... something has changed. And now, more than ever, you need to trust me. And maybe this will help.
Whoa.
Easy there, cowboy. These belong to your father. I used to think he left these for our protection. But they might as well be paperweights. Still, if they're enough to convince you of who he really was, then maybe they're protection enough.
Protection from what?
Your father wasn't just from another planet, Peter. He was important. And important men have enemies.
What do you mean, important?
He was king of an entire world called Spartax, far, far away. And he was a great leader. And the way you look after people, Peter, I know you're going to be just like him. But leading is never easy. Your father left to protect us. And for 13 years it worked. But now something's coming. I know we're being watched.
Mom, if you really wanted to play a game that bad, you could have just said so.
I hope I'm wrong, Peter. I really do. But being the son of a king on any planet means that you are going to have a target on your back for the rest of your life. And you're plenty brave, but you're gonna have to be smart, too. Things may get messy. I'm gonna let Kubrick out. I'll be right back.
Sick. Oh, shit.
No!
No! Please, no!
What the? Hello, buddy. What are you doing there?
You scuts got lucky. Yeah.
Don't hate it, but we should.
Cause what?
Peter Quill, what does killing two birds with one stone signify?
So those coordinates. Nowhere, here we come. Nowhere. Last spaceport on the edge of the known universe and home to the best black market deal. If found, it was like, oh look! And as such, probably deals in Novacore all the time. Trust me, he's gonna want to know about the rock.
What are they doing back there?
Shenanigans, likely.
See you never, flark bags!
Are Rocket and Groot, did they really leave?
Yes.
It looks like it.
I can't even find the hard
light. Do we know where they went?
Without Rocket.
Well,
here.
Did you end up talking to Rocket after he stormed out of the rec room?
Don't think he was in a talking mood.
Fine, whatever. We'll talk to Cosmo and then we'll go out and have a good time. Like I said, we go way back.
Plus, he's probably already heard about what's happening. All we do is confirm the rumor. Maybe he'll even give us a reward.
I can't wait to see the rift.
What about Rocket and Groot?
What about them? They left. What am I supposed to do? Chase them down and beg them to come back?
You could apologize.
That's your advice?
The apology does not need to be sincere.
I guess if we ever see him again. Big if, by the way. But if it happens, then maybe I might think about it. Anyway, once we let Cosmo know what's happening out there, we'll have more time to think about what to do with Rocket.
If Rocket doesn't come back, we'll need a contingency plan for getting rid of the Nova Tracker.
Why? We have not yet spent our ill-gotten gains. Where do we find this Cosmo?
We head to his tower on the far side of the market. That's where he keeps an eye on things. It's good to see Cosmo again. I guess I kind of miss the old boy.
How exactly do you know him?
Was he also a prisoner of the Chitauri?
Nope, he met right here, back when I was in the Ravagers.
Dishonorable killers and thieves.
The Ravagers actually did some good during the war.
Whatever bad stuff we all did is behind us. We're the good guys now.
Right, heroes for hire. Except no one will hire us.
Maybe Cosmo will have a fetch quest for us or something. He might even come out ahead on this. Keep an eye on your things. These kooks are a bit hands-on, if you know what I mean.
Soothsayers on Katath were unable to predict its demise.
No one could predict what Thanos would do.
Mad Titan will pay for everything that he has done.
Mantis, what are you...
Star Guy? Okay, bye.
So, Gamora, you and Mantis seem close.
We've met.
Okay. You're being evasive, woman.
Wait, woman?
I'm not gonna ask, but if you wanted to talk about it...
We met after I escaped from a failed job. I was in bad shape. I'd probably be dead if Mantis hadn't found me.
She saved your life.
Yep. End of story.
That is not the end of the story.
I know, big...
I need to leave.
Something wrong?
It's not your business, Peter Quill. Do not wait for me.
What the heck was that?
Drax!
Watch it, Star-Lord!
Watch yourself, jerky red guy!
Can you believe that?
Gamora!
I must go talk to Cosmo alone.
Lots more ghosts hanging around.
Cynical for me.
Enough to me.
You want to know another secret?
Okay.
Something you bet is happening. Something great. Do you want to hear about it?
Sure.
I don't hate it, but...
Peter Quill, what does killing two birds with one stone signify?
So those coordinates?
They're in your console.
Got it. Nowhere, here we come. Yeah. spaceport on the edge of the known universe and home to the best black market deal. Everyone found it was like, oh look! And as such, probably deals in Novacore all the time. Trust me, he's gonna want to know about the Rock.
What are they doing back there?
Shenanigans, likely.
See you never, flark bags!
Are Rocket and Groot, did they really leave?
Yes.
It looks like it.
Do we know where they went?
Well, did you end up talking to Rocket after he stormed out of the rec room?
Don't think he was in a talking mood.
Fine, whatever. We'll talk to Cosmo and then we'll go out and have a good time.
Like I said, we go way back. Plus, he's probably already heard about what's happening. All we do is confirm the rumor. Maybe he'll even give us a reward.
I can't wait to see the rift.
What about Rocket and Groot?
What about them? They left. What am I supposed to do? Chase them down and beg them to come back?
You could apologize.
That's your advice?
I guess if we ever see him again. Big if, by the way. But if it happens, then maybe I might think about it. Anyway, once we let Cosmo know what's happening out there, we'll have more time to think about what to do with Rocket.
If Rocket doesn't come back, we'll need a contingency plan for getting rid of the Nova Tracker.
Why? We've not yet spent our ill-gotten gains. Where do we find this Cosmo?
We head to his tower on the far side of the market. That's where he keeps an eye on things. Be good to see Cosmo again. I guess I kind of miss the old boy.
How exactly do you know him?
Was he also a prisoner of the Chitauri?
Nope, he met right here, back when I was in the Ravagers.
Dishonorable killers and thieves.
The Ravagers actually did some good during the war.
Even the mangiest of mutts will behave, and it befits them.
Whatever bad stuff we all did is behind us. We're the good guys now.
Right, heroes for hire. Except no one will hire us.
Keep an eye on your things. Coops are a bit hands-on, if you know what I mean.
They have fortune-tellers on Earth, Peter Quill. Soothsayers on Katath were unable to predict its demise.
No one could predict what Thanos would do.
Mantis, what?
Starguy? Green? Okay, bye.
So, Gamora, you and Mantis seem close.
We've met.
Okay.
You're being evasive, woman.
Wait, woman?
I'm not gonna ask, but if you wanted to talk about it...
We met after I escaped from a failed job. I was in bad shape. I'd probably be dead if Mantis hadn't found me.
She saved your life.
Yep. End of story.
That is not the end of it.
Hey, dude! Hi, Groot. Rocket, you can't... Just ignore me! We gotta talk about this!
So, you want us to bring them back here?
Not necessary. Transport will be waiting once you capture the target.
That'll work. We'll be in touch. Let's go, Groot.
What's the big idea, man?
Think you got me confused with somebody else, pal.
Come on, Rocket. Let's talk about this.
Can
making you believe this guy?
You can't just quit. We need you.
I don't need you. Find some other sucker to keep your ship together.
You're more than just...
I know that blonde mop anywhere. Itaquil!
Actually, maybe we can stick around for a bit.
Last time I see you, you was running away from Mordidia. With your bridges, off and done.
Get ready for a fight.
I'm always ready.
What the? I don't know what's going on here, but I thought we was friends, Eta. Or did you forget about me?
No, I don't remember meeting you, man. Sorry.
How the hell could you forget?
Look, there was a couple of years there where things got a little bit blurry, okay? They're, you know, picking up missions, strange women, alien alcohol.
So just like now?
I can't believe this. You and me,
Storm Riders,
together till the end.
What is he talking about?
Oh, it's a song, right?
It is.
Of course it's a song. The one that was playing when Peter and me made our unbreakable blood oath.
We did?
Unbreakable blood oath? That is a serious commitment, Peter Quill.
Oh, no, wait, of course, I remember. You, me, the music.
Tells you what, Peter. How about you and me? Storm ride together! One more time.
Here we go!
You wanted to sing a song.
Together till the end, gotta finish the fight. Cause this storm's gonna rage till the end of the night. Come on, Lita! Together! Roaring like a hurricane!
Right, storm!
Storm Riders! Very nice!
Bartender, get me a cocktail stick. I need to poke my ears out.
Come on, man.
What?
Let's sing the next line. More! Together till the end, now we look to the sky. Lightning strikes twice now. Now we talk through the fly. Sing with me, Rita. Driving through the pouring rain.
Come
on. Yes.
For Flark's sake, let's go, Groot.
Good times! You running the Ravagers now? I hear Yondu's doing time in the kiln.
Me? Me, no. I got a new crew now. You? Still doing that, thing you do?
No, sorry. Novacore, now my partner on Mollilia. But that's okay. I got a new business partner now. Into animal husbandry, you can say. Ain't no animal gonna have no husbands after she's through with them. Which reminds me, I best be going.
Oh, really? That's too bad.
Well, listen, Peter. I want to apologize for almost shooting you.
Oh, you weren't actually gonna shoot me?
Oh, I would have. Right in the head.
Oh.
But that's not the way to treat a storm rider, is it? Right, so I got you this instead.
What is it?
It's a ticket for Collector's Emporium. Yeah, I bought it thinking I'd have time to go and check out the oddities.
Wow, thanks, man. That's awesome.
Yeah, my pleasure. And remember,
the storm, storm riders, storm riders.
Okay. Bye.
Nice one, Peter.
Could have been worse. Where's Rocket?
The rodent left the bar once he realized you would not be killed.
Great.
Something's up.
I need to leave.
Something wrong?
It's not your business, Peter Quill. Do not wait for me.
What the heck was that?
Drax!
Watch it, Star-Lord!
Watch yourself, jerky bread guy!
Can you believe that?
Gamora?
Let's go talk to Cosmo alone.
Lucky traveler, have arrived at the Illustrious Emporium, private collection of Tanalir Teyvat, the premier exhibit of wonders in the galaxy. Most would hoard these treasures, but not Mr. Teyvat. He is so generous. He wishes to share them with the common people. Would you like to take the tour?
I'd love a tour. Oh! I have this. Think I get in for free, right?
Oh my! You must be a very important person. Mr. Teyvat does not give these out very, very, very often. Please enjoy the Emporium.
Greatest collection of gifts.
What is this place?
You have stumbled into the wonderful Emporium's gift shop. Would you like to purchase a souvenir? We have some very unique items.
Maybe. What kind of things do you sell?
Replicas of very rare items. Figures and effigies from lost civilizations. Objets d'art, in other words.
Figures? Like dolls? There's a member of my crew, a woman, who might like that kind of thing.
A boorish person might call them dolls, but that is neither here nor there. Tell me more about this person.
She, also likes swords.
Oh, not what does she like. What is she like?
Oh, distant and tough. But I think maybe there might be some squishy bits in her somewhere.
Ah, I believe I have the perfect item. What do you think? Would you like to make a purchase?
just the right kind of creepy. She should love it.
A magnificent choice. I presume you will forgo the silk gift wrap.
Yeah, this is fine as is.
Very well. Enjoy your purchase. Good day. Enjoy the wonders of the Emporium.
Kinda neat. Oh, cool. I don't get it. Fancy. No way! How'd they get that? Huh, interesting. Dude, no way! That's not good. Dude, no way! I don't get it. No way! How'd they get that? Fancy. Kinda neat. Huh, interesting. Oh, cool. I don't get it. Fancy. No way! How'd they get that? Kinda neat. Huh, interesting. Thank you. tracks, bud. Is everything all right?
Do you believe that this is the edge of the universe, Peter Quill?
Well, yeah, because it is. So, this is the thing you had to do? Come to the observation deck to look at the rift?
No. I came to honor the memory of my family. They died without meaning or honor.
I think I know what you mean, man. My mom won the Chitara game. She also died for no reason. They just shot her. But at least she's in a better place now. Right?
In Katathian religion, we believe that in order to reach Untaf, one must lead a life filled with purpose. Failure to do so results in banishment to Sarduth. Our families have been cast out of paradise, Peter Quill, and into nothing.
So that's why you come up here.
Yes. To feel close to them. Speak to them. Perhaps you think that sounds foolish.
No, no. Not at all. You know, on Earth, a lot of people think that good people go to heaven and are reunited with their loved ones when they die.
This heaven sounds pleasant.
Yeah, it does. Thinking of her there, my mom, in heaven, got me halfway through the war. That and my hate for the Chitauri who imprisoned me.
You desired revenge.
Yeah, I guess I did.
When Thanos murdered my family, for a long time I believed that their wasted lives would be redeemed if I took revenge on him. But then I realized Thanos cannot be killed.
But you did kill him.
Propaganda, Peter Quill. Spread to quell fears after the war. The fabric of my being, I know he still lives. If you do not mind, Peter Quill, I would like to be left alone now.
Yeah, sure, man.
Peter Quill.
Yeah.
I hope your mother found her way to heaven.